This is Bring Your A-Game Sports Talk Radio, and I'm backing your ear down here in the Playa Cave flying solo dolo. It's your host, the Blaq Hippie, delivering y'all right here on this Monday. Hope y'all been doing cool and enjoying this weather, man. I got a few topics I want to talk about. Today, we're going to discuss Bulls basketball. Discuss a little bit of Bears basketball. Not basketball, what I'm talking about, Bears football. I'm sitting up here reading and thinking at the same time. We're going to discuss Bulls basketball, Bears football. We're going to talk about White Sox. You got them Yankees. They're always trying to steal a star from somewhere. Well, they got one of our stars in their eyes, man. They got Jose Quintana. We'll talk more about that story. You can find that story on BringYourAGameSportsTalk.com. Also, it's been rumors floating around that Rose might be the next guard wave. So I'm going to talk a little bit about that right here on this podcast. But, you know, Bring Your A-Game Sports Talk Radio. You know, you can catch it at 5 p.m. every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And right now it's sitting at 5 p.m. I'm thinking about changing to 7, you know, just to build it up a little bit more. You get what I'm saying? But at this point, it stands at 5 p.m., man. You know, like I say, I'm right down here in the Playa Cave on this Monday, February the 27th. We only got one more day left in this Black History Month. So, you know, y'all go out there and y'all do y'all part, you know. Even though Black History Month is every month for me. But, you know, we do just get this particular legal one, I guess. You know, be back in y'all here, yeah, man. Up first, man, I got some Dipset. Diplomats. Dipset after. Back, y'all.
Come on. Fuck with your boy. Yeah. It's Santana. Once again. Hey, man. Oh, yeah. Let me see you do this. Jello. Jim. Freaking. Yeah, man. I'm back at it. Come on. Today's a new day. Got the bootay up in the suitcase. So go uptown to Harlem. Tell them that I sent ya. Yep. Tell them it's August, I'm going to November. I need a couple birds, get abroad, have them sent up. Call my bird, get my broad, have her sent up. Please. Call my niggas, call my squad, have them sent up. Please. Yeah, I see a town I'm liking. See some niggas getting money in a town I like it. Yeah. I run up on them with the pound and light it. Like it's my block now, alright, kid. He understood me quite clear. Then that thing bang out and rang out the side of his right ear. And I got back to my business, back to my bitches, back to the kitchen at Pyrex Vision. Pop, I let that white stuff sit in. Get hard, get rock, get to the block and pitch it. Yeah, I'm sorry, but this is how I'm living, and this is how I'm getting. Come fuck no more with this
old hand on my handle, listening to gangster music. Hey, I stood at home, hand on the chrome and zone, flicking the cameras, watching how the gangsters do it. Say with me. I stood alone getting dome from a thick chicken sandwich. Watch
now I see death mad around the corner. Gotta stay high now, will I survive in a city where the skinny niggas die? Nope, it's the city where the skinny niggas ride. Yeah, 4-5 send me on their side. Yeah, twisted when they drive. Yeah, liquor shot. Yeah, big pop and pop. Yeah, one more for Shine locked inside. Yeah, two more for Cam for taking over the rock. Yeah, yeah, it's my year, so. Okay, okay, okay. Y'all can't fuck with me, no way.
What?
Jose or Hector Camacho. Check blowing racho, chest clothes and tacos. Motherfucker, I'm the best. I told y'all before, I showed y'all before. Hey,
I stood alone watching the wall in his own hand on my handle, listening to gangster music. Hey, I stood at home, hand on the chrome in his own flicking the cameras, watching how the gangsters do it. Say it with me. I stood alone getting dome from a thick chicken sandwich. Watch your shaft, clocking math.
Clocking math, okay. Man. I want you, Santana. This the union right here. Let's do it one time. Dipset, bitch. I know you can't fuck with the boy. Killer.
I'm on the west side of Chicago looking for a bus stand to make me put my two arms up. Touchdown, you stay in touch now. But when I touch down, I'm like buckshot shorty, duck down. Yeah, I must clown, I'm from Harlem Uptown. When we flash money, take your bitch and ask you what now. Bird flip a dozen, chicks is dicks, they suckin'. Swallow my kids, go and kiss they cousin. Guess they kissin' cousins, toys kissin' muffin. Worse than that, they go home and kiss they husband. This shit's disgusting, keep the chickens cluckin'. Keep the pigeons buggin'.
my wrist is nothing. It's just yellow hearts and pink diamonds. Where I get the money for this, don't think rhyming. You fucking with Pablo, Bravo, Mario, Via Bono, Ho, Tato.
I stood alone watching the wall in the zone, hand on my handle, listening to gangster music. I stood at home, hand on the chrome in the zone, flicking the candles, watching how the gangsters do it. Say what? I stood alone watching the wall in the zone, hand on my handle, listening to gangster music.
Bring it, A-Gang Sports Talk Radio. Down here in the Playa Cave, I'm your host, the Blaq Hippie, delivering you this podcast right here on this Monday, February 27th. Like I said, I'm down here in the Playa Cave solo dolo. Smokey D, he out today, man. He a little bit under the weather, but I am going to get him on the phone, see if we can talk about this. Oh, yeah. Blaq Hippie Radio Entertainment. Bring A-Game Sports Talk, the live and direct show. We'll be able to take call-ins, plus make phone calls going out. So it's more you, the listener, all the listeners that's in different countries and in different states or all around the Chicagoland area. You know, y'all can call in and talk, or, you know, we can call and talk. You know, y'all can leave voicemails. We can play the voicemails or whatever. You know, how y'all felt about everything else, you know. It just is what it is. I'm going to post that number up on the website. Probably later on today, I got to get a few of the bugs worked out. Today is going to be the first test run with the call in with Smokey D and everything. But up first, man, we're going to discuss these Bulls. They done won four out of their last five, since everything been just upside down, you know, not to mention two games before the All-Star break, you know. So, I mean, who knows? Maybe this trade might be what they needed, you know, or just a whole new look. You know, Taj was the last person left over from the Thibodeau regime, you know. So, I mean, hey, who knows? This could be a big thing. The Bulls bench, you know, since this streak, this four-game winning streak, which is the first winning streak this season, first four-game winning streak. Man, I mean, we used to get those a lot. But anyway, ain't going to talk about old times. The bench is averaging like 49.3. You know, that's big. That's huge from a bench, you know, in these last four games. You know, you're starting to see more flashes of Denzel. You know, Denzel Valentine coming out, and you know he's playing with much more confidence. He said that, you know, he is a little bit more confident because now he doesn't have to look over his shoulder. Meaning that, you know, McDermott was there, and you can see that. And I said that in previous podcasts. You know, it just takes time. You know, the game, you have to have experience. You have to have game-to-game experience in order to, you know, flourish in this game. You know, practicing and, you know, and putting scenarios out there, you know, just ain't gonna do it. Sometimes you have to be in a real game situation in order to understand how to, you know, play the game. But, you know, the last game the Bulls played, they played the Heat. They played the Cavs. I want to say the Heat, thinking about LeBron James' ass. They played the Cavs. And they played them boys. They played them pretty good. Pretty tough, man. You know, the young fellas, they was out there, you know, just doing what they had to do in order to get the job done. You know, I was a little worried, you know, going up against them Cleveland Cavaliers without, you know, Taj down there, you know. So, yeah, you know, we as fans, we become used to and we get accustomed to certain players. And that's one thing myself I got to stop to. I really don't get accustomed to them, but, you know what I'm saying, I do get, like, a little bit of attachment. You know what I'm saying? And I got to stop that. So I guess it is basically the same thing, man. But just in case you missed that game, you know, Jimmy had a triple-double. 18, 10 rebounds, and 10 assists with a steal. You know, so he filling up the stat boards. You had Portis with 7 and 3 rebounds. Yeah, Rob Lopez, 10, 1 rebound, 1 assist, and 1 steal. So then you had Wade. 20, 9 rebounds and 10 assists. So it was almost a triple-double from Butler and Wade. You know, Wade was just one off. You had Jerry Grant, 6 points, 3 rebounds, 2 assists. You had Nico. He had 14, 10, and 1. Yeah, Valentine again, you know. I take these stats, 11-2-2. Rondo, 15-2-5. We need more of that. Felicio, you know, he 10-5-1. Payne came in and, you know, I saw the game. I saw a little bit of the game before I left to make a few runs. You know, Payne came in and I seen him shooting that ball with confidence, you know, and that's the thing that I liked that I saw. You know, it was like they were playing out there, we playing out there with confidence with each other, you know. And let me see. Oh yeah, that's what I forgot to mention. Sitting up here. James stayed home with the throat, you know, that game. So that could be one thing, but still, you know, you still play the game, you have to come out and play, man. You know, people could say that's probably the reason why the Bulls did what they did because LeBron was out, but my same thing is, you know, it's be professionals, you know, play the game. You know, you come up with all type of excuses if you want to, you know, but the Bulls won. And, you know, so it is what it is. So you got your stats, you got your Bulls and everything else. The Bulls sitting number 6 in the East right now for the playoff race. They actually 11, but I think like 11.5 or 10.5 out of first. So, you know, they only 8.5 out of second, you know. So it's a long second half of the season, and they can pull it off if they pull it together, man. They really can pull it off and pull it together. So, and I'm hoping this is just more bigger things to come for the Bulls by beating up on the Cleveland Cavaliers. That final score was 117-99, Bulls winning. Like I mentioned before, they sit number 6 in the East, man. So, I mean, moving forward, you know, they just gotta take care of business. You know, these young fellas, they look energetic, like they want to play and they want to make a difference. So, you know, Hoiberg, take advantage of it, man, and you know, don't make no dumb mistakes. You know, because us fans are suffering, man. We suffering with this, man. These teams and we under not knowing what the hell going on, man. You know, so but. On the plus side, 4 out of 5. That's all I can say, Chicago. That's a good thing. You know, that's good music to our ears, man. You know, we turn on the radio and know that your team has won 4 out of their last 5 games when before then they were losing 2 and 3 in a row, you know. So, damn. We gonna get I'm gonna get Smokey D, man. I'm gonna take a small little break. See if I get Smokey D on right here on this line and talk right here on Bring Your 8-Game Sports Talk Radio down here in the Playa Cave. Hope y'all been enjoying this nice-ass day, this Monday, February 27th, right here in Chicagoland. Up next, I got Snoop Dogg. Beautiful, girl, I want you to know you're my favorite girl. This is Bring Your 8-Game Sports Talk Radio. I'll be back in your ear. This is the Blaq Hippie.
Snoop shit, come on baby boo, you got to get into it. Going forward to play with the cool wit. Yeah, you know I'm always on that cool shit. Walk to it, do it how you do it. Have a blast, let me put you in the mood. Little cupid, looking like a student. Long hair with your big fat booty. Back in the days you was the girl I went to school with. Had to tell your mom and sister to cool it. The girl wanna do it, I just might do it. Hit her off with some pimp fluid. Mommy don't worry, I won't abuse it. Hurry up and finish so you can watch Clueless. I laugh at these niggas when they ask who do this, but everybody know who girl that you is.
Beautiful.